Can you say meningitis?
Meningitis.
Okay.
I can say that.
Meningitis. Hearing the word meningitis can be pretty scary, especially if it has to do with you or your family member. The good news is that meningitis can sometimes be prevented through vaccinations. I'm Dr. Kathleen Shapley-Quinn, Medical Director of the Alamance County Health Department, and I'm here to educate young people, especially preteens and their parents, about a new vaccine that can help prevent some forms of meningitis.
The Alamance County Health Department presents Recognizing and Preventing Meningitis. What is meningitis?
So meningitis is a word that means inflammation of the meninges. A logical question, of course, is what are the meninges? And these are thin tissue paper-like coverings over the brain and spinal cord. They generally serve to protect the brain, but rarely can get infected. And infections of meninges, or meningitis, can be horrible.
What causes meningitis?
Lots of things can cause meningitis. This includes infections from viruses or bacteria, but also people sometimes get meningitis from cancer or from bleeding in the skull.
Tell me about meningitis caused by bacteria.
First of all, I think it's good to focus on bacterial meningitis in this discussion because some types can be prevented with an immunization. There are several different kinds of bacteria that can cause meningitis, and one kind of meningitis we protect against with immunizations given to babies. This immunization is called the HIB vaccine, which stands for Haemophilus Influenza Type B, not to be confused with the influenza virus that causes the flu most years. A second type of meningitis is called meningococcal meningitis. The name of the bacteria that causes this is equally unusual, Neisseria meningitidis. Meningococcal meningitis is very scary because it can make people very ill very quickly, and people can also die quickly from this infection.
Is meningococcal meningitis contagious?
It is contagious, but usually not very contagious. It's spread much like the common cold through coughing, sneezing, and other forms of close contact. You can't simply get it by breathing the air where a person with meningitis has been. There are, however, some situations in which meningitis is more contagious than usual. For instance, we've learned through research that first-year college students who live in a dormitory together are more likely to catch this infection than other adults. The most important thing to remember is if you've had close or prolonged contact with someone who's had meningococcal meningitis, you should talk to your doctor. You may need to begin an antibiotic treatment as a precaution. Your doctor will be able to tell you for sure.
How would I know if I had meningitis?
For children and adults, the symptoms of meningitis include high fever, headache, and stiff neck. These symptoms can develop over several hours or they may take 1 to 2 days. Other symptoms may include nausea or vomiting. People may be confused or feel unusually sleepy. As you can tell, some of these symptoms are present with lots of illnesses, so in answer to your question about how you would know if you had meningitis, you will need to see a doctor to know for sure. Blood tests and tests of the fluid around the meninges may be necessary. Babies and toddlers, on the other hand, can be quite ill even if they don't have the changes we talked about in older children and in adults. You should always check with your doctor if your newborn or young child is not eating well. Is sleeping more than usual, is more fussy than usual, or anything that's just not normal for your baby.
Is meningitis treatable?
Sometimes. If you or your child show the symptoms we just talked about, you should get medical care immediately. Just to reiterate, if you or your child has had contact with someone with meningitis, you should call your doctor to determine whether there is a need to take medication.
How can I prevent catching meningitis?
Well, the best thing you can do to prevent getting sick with a lot of different infections, including bacteria that cause meningitis, is wash your hands thoroughly and frequently and avoid close contact with people who are sick. You can also prevent some forms of meningitis by getting vaccinated. There are two vaccines which protect people against meningococcal meningitis. While they don't protect against all forms of meningococcal meningitis, they do cover some of the most common types. The first of these two vaccines is recommended only in situations when people have unusual medical problems. Check with your doctor if you think this may apply to you. The other meningococcal vaccine, called Menactra, is the meningitis vaccine which is currently recommended for all children over 11 years of age before they enter high school. It is also recommended for college students living in dormitories, military recruits, people with immune system disorders, people who are traveling to areas of the world where meningitis is common, and people who are otherwise exposed to the disease.
Are there any concerns with this vaccination?
About 2 to 3% of people who receive this vaccine feel ill for 2 to 3 days with symptoms of fever, tiredness, diarrhea, or rash. Most people, though, will have only mild symptoms such as tiredness, achiness, or fever if they have any symptoms at all. While there is some risk of not feeling well with this vaccine, we encourage you to strongly consider this vaccine for you or your teenage children. It is effective for protecting against some of the types of meningitis which infect college students. Talk to your healthcare provider for further information.
If I want this vaccine or have more questions, where can I get more information?
Your healthcare provider may offer this vaccine in their office. This vaccine is also available at the Alamance County Health Department. Please call us at 336-227-0101 for more information or for an appointment. Thank you, and remember, be safe, be healthy, and be prepared.